Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you what is Bitcoin halving, its effects, and why is it needed. So let's get started. To state simply, after every 210,000 blocks mined, or roughly in every 4 years, the block rewards given to Bitcoin miners for processing transactions is cut in half. This automatic event is referred to as Bitcoin halving because it divides the rate by half at which new Bitcoins are released into circulation. And while some might say that this is Bitcoin's way of enforcing synthetic price inflation until all Bitcoins are released, many believe that this is gonna go on forever. Well, sorry to break your heart, this would never be forever, as once the proposed limit of 21 million coins is reached, which is estimated to be around the year 2140, this cycle of getting block rewards would stop. At that point, miners will start getting rewarded with fees, which network users will pay for processing their transactions. These fees will then ensure that miners still have the incentive to mine and keep the network going. The halving event is significant because it marks another drop in the rate of new Bitcoins being produced as it approaches the finite supply of 21 million. And now that you understand what is Bitcoin halving, it's time to know what happens to Bitcoin prices during halving. To answer this in one line, it surely does increases the price of Bitcoin, but still, here's a summary of what happened around the first three halving events. First halving, it occurred in November 2012. Back then, the price of Bitcoin stood at about $11, and within a year, it rose by 100-fold. Up next, second halving. In July 2016, the Bitcoin network arrived at the milestone of 420,000 blocks and triggered a second halving. The price of Bitcoin fluctuated between $500 to $1,000 for a few months and ultimately rose around $20,000 by the end of December 2017. And lastly, third halving. This halving happened in May 2020, coinciding with another bull run for cryptocurrencies. At the time of this halving, Bitcoin traded around $9,000 and climbed the highest around $35,000 by the end of the year. Further, in 2009, the reward for each block in the chain mined was 50 Bitcoins. After first halving, it was 25, then it was 12.5, and then it became 6.25 Bitcoins per block as of May 11, 2020. And when the next halving occurs, the block will only contain 3.125 BTC. You must be thinking now, why is Bitcoin halving needed, or what would happen without halving in Bitcoin? To answer this famous question, let's follow the facts. If there would have been no Bitcoin halving, all Bitcoins would have been mined till now. And so, miners will only receive transaction fees with little cost as compensation. Why, you ask? Simply because it would have taken few years for all the Bitcoins to be put in circulation. Let's support this with maths. Initially, 50 Bitcoins per block was distributed, which is 300 Bitcoins per hour or 7200 Bitcoins per day. An amount of close to 2.6 million Bitcoins would have been released annually, which if we divide by total possible Bitcoins, which is 21 million, gives us almost 8 years of time it would have taken to put all Bitcoins into circulation. Now, I hope you understand it. Next, let's look into consequences that Bitcoin halving offers on different levels. Firstly, let's start with consequences for a normal user. To your surprise, for anyone who uses Bitcoin in their daily life, when someone transacts or sends money around the world, there is no consequences at all. You can continue to use your portfolio as normal as you have done so far. But if we see consequences for a Bitcoin miner, things would be different. Now, as miners are more important players in the case, the effect would be a little complicated. On one hand, a diminishing Bitcoin supply will increase demand and further prices. But at the same time, fewer rewards will also make it difficult for individual miners or small mining outfits to survive in Bitcoin's ecosystem, because they may find it difficult to compete with large mining organizations. So, in a few days after halving, we usually see if the same computing power is maintained by mining on the network, or if the miners stop mining due to high cost and little reward for them. And I'm saying this based on an assumption that the price of Bitcoin does not rise in the market. Thirdly, looking at the consequences for speculators, we can say that a halving might be perfect time to start raising the price of Bitcoin, as the new rewards will make Bitcoin increasingly rare. This, of course, happens because the extraction of Bitcoin is reduced, and this leads to the demand being greater than the supply. And this thus increases the price of Bitcoin, and those who know how to handle themselves in these circumstances will be able to obtain greater profits. Next, now that we know about the consequences, let's talk about halving and its effects. The theory of halving and the chain reaction that it sets off works something like this. The reward is halved, which results in half the inflation, which further results in lower available supply, which eventually produces higher demand, which in turn results in higher price, but miner's incentives still remains, regardless of small rewards, as the value of Bitcoin increases in the process. But hey, it's not all. If in case a halving does not increase demand and price, then miners would have no incentive. The rewards for completing transactions would be smaller, and the value of Bitcoin would be not big enough in return. To prevent this, Bitcoin has a process to change the difficulty it takes to get mining rewards, or in other words, the difficulty of mining a transaction. Now, here if you see, rewards have been halved and the value of Bitcoin has not increased, but still the difficulty of mining would be reduced to keep miners incentivized. This means that the quantity of Bitcoins released as a reward is still smaller, but the difficulty of processing a transaction is reduced, and this process has proved successful twice so far. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.